Okay, so hi everyone. My name is Sabina Vidal, and I'm so happy and proud to introduce Ale. She is a very bright, intelligent, extremely hardworking, and determined student at Eastside Prep. She is a ninth grader, and she has really high aspirations to become a civil engineer. So mentoring her has been such an honor. I actually see a lot of myself in her. And so it was really, really great to see her succeed, help see her learn, and to help her, to be a guiding light to her. I've really enjoyed everything with her. So her high interest in civil engineering and her curiosity in learning how to code yielded this want to create an app, and specifically an iOS app that will help civil engineers determine the completion of their project. So welcome, Ale. So hola, buenas tardes. Also, feliz día de las madres. Mi nombre es Divina y estoy muy muy feliz de introducir a Ale. Ella es muy inteligente, muy trabajadora, tiene muchísima motivación, su presencia es muy fuerte y es una estudiante que quiere ser una ingeniera civil. Siendo una mentora por ella ha sido un honor en verla trabajar, en verla aprender cosas y todo. Eso estoy muy, muy proud. So ella decidió en hacer una aplicación de iPhone que ayuda a los ingenieros civiles a determinar si sus proyectos están completos. So, bienvenida, Ale.
Hola, hi, Amale. So my mentor, Divina Vidal. So she works at Viadome. She is a software QA engineer, and she's from Mexico. Some hobbies of hers are cooking recipes, doing her nails, teaching and playing with her daughters, and a fun fact is that she has a twin. Divina es mi mentor y ella trabaja en Phylum. Divina, do you know what a software QA engineer, how to say it in Spanish?
Ingeniera de software de calidad.
Ella viene de México y ella le gusta cocinar, hacer sus uñas, jugar con sus hijas y ella es una gemela. Next slide, please. So, what is my project? So, there's a lot of screens going on here. So, my project, as Divina said, is an app, an iOS app that helps civil engineers communicate with other civil engineers to help with their projects, like blueprints. Entonces, mi proyecto es una aplicación en iPhone que ayuda a los ingenieros civiles a encontrar personas para que les ayude con sus proyectos, como las matemáticas y cosas así. Next slide, please. So, my magical experience. Some highlights of magic have been getting to know Divina and being gifted with a temporary laptop to help me with this project. Some lessons learned is confusion can be good. So being confused will lead to questions, which will lead to be answered, and I will gain knowledge, learning. Entonces, esta experiencia de este programa, unas cosas buenas es mi mentor Divina, conociéndola y hacer como su su amiga. Y este programa me regaló para un cierto tiempo una computadora para ayudarme con este proyecto. Y una lección que aprendí es, a veces hacer confundida no es malo y puede ser algo bueno, porque ahí puedes hacer preguntas que te ayudan en el futuro. Next slide, please. So, some challenges and some successes. So, a challenge, two challenges have been coding as a beginner. Coding has a lot. Coding is very strict, it's very straightforward. You know, it can be a lot. App design, designing an app seems easy, but there's a lot. There's colors, there's aesthetics, shapes, no open space. Some successes, playgrounds. Playgrounds is an app that I will show you on the next slide. And storyboard is what you saw on the screen where it was my projects. So, yeah. So, algo difícil, dos cosas difíciles para mí era Irina. Coding as a beginner.
So hacer el código como una Melanie, how do you say beginner?
Como un principiante.
Principiante. I had that in my mind. Eso como era su primera vez de que iba a hacer coding. Se le hizo muy dificultoso porque hay muchísimas reglas. So, una cosa que sí le dije a ella era de que a empezar a hacer coding es como empezar a aprender un lenguaje completamente nuevo. Porque eso es lo que es un lenguaje que la computadora conoce. Y los lenguajes, como una lenguaje de humana, tiene ciertas reglas, ciertas puntuaciones, y si uno hace algo malo, no, la otra persona no va a entender. Es lo mismo si hace uno algo malo en el código, la computadora no va a saber.
Thank you, Divina. So, el diseño de las aplicaciones en el teléfono también era difícil para mí porque el diseño es difícil. A veces no sabes dónde poner unas cosas, no sabes qué colores se van a mirar bien, entonces tienes que hacer uno, hacer otro, ¿cuál te gusta más? Tienes que mirar tus opciones y hay muchas opciones en diseño. Y algo bien que aprendí era una aplicación que se llama Playgrounds. Voy a explicar más en next slide. Storyboard. Oh, okay. Next. So,
Sorry.
Playgrounds. This is
Okay.
Playgrounds. So, as you see Byte. He's a little banana creature. And basically, all you do is you have to help him kind of like go through the paths, no code, help Byte succeed in life. And to do so, you have to do coding. So in mine, I added Swift, which is a coding language. I had to help Byte. And I helped Byte. Okay. Esto es Playgrounds. Aquí en esta aplicación, como miras, tiene códigos. Tienes que ayudar a esta persona, creo que es una persona, que se llama Byte. Y Byte quiere hacer muchas cosas y nosotros necesitamos ayudarle con el código. Next slide. So, my mockups. Mockups is an app where you can design, which is where I did my draft. So you can see it's a little rough. It's a little rough looking. So, mockups, screenshots, This is one screenshot. I only did six screens, as you saw on the What Is My Projects, there was not six screens. So there's a lot to really think about, which I didn't know. But now I know. So it's okay. So this was my first time designing an app. And it was a little difficult. There was a lot of options, but it was pretty fun. Entonces, aquí, una aplicación que se llama Mockups es una aplicación en donde puedes diseñar cosas. Y yo escogí, pues, hacer la aplicación. Aquí nomás hay seis. Como miraste en My Projects, no había seis. Había muchas porque no sabía que cada. Oh my gosh, I forgot a word for button.
Botón.
Botón. Cada botón necesita otra página. Y yo no. En este momento no pensé eso. Nomás estaba pensando qué colores se miran más bien. Cómo quiero que se mira esta aplicación. Esta era mi primera vez hacer esto. Y era divertido. Pero es fun. Next slide, please. All right, so this is a video. Este es un video.
Hello, today I will be showing you all my Manage It.
Ale, you can explain it while it's running.
So, I actually am explaining it in the video, so.
Do you want me to play it with the video on? It's easier for you if you explain and the video is off. I can start it from the beginning. Will you explain it?
Yeah, you can start from the beginning because in the video, I kind of like show the screen and then I'm like, so
Do you
the
want
one
me
thing
to
I'm gonna
put
need
the
to do
audio on?
is,
Do you want me to put the audio on also?
yeah, please play the audio.
Hey, I will be showing you all my
Play the
magic.
whole video.
So the first screen you will see is the sign-in page. In this demonstration of the app, I will just explain what screens do. So let's say you did not have an account, so you have to sign up for one, which we would go right here. This is the information that manager would ask for: your email, password to confirm your password, of course, your username, which is the username that will be displayed when they click on your profile, and the type of engineer you are. Then your profile would be created. In your profile, you have a profile photo, your username, and a bio where you can briefly just a little description of yourself as an engineer. Then, if we press settings, it will take us to my account. So, in personal information is information like the birthday and the type of engineer you are. Here in settings, is just like the app settings, so where you can enable your information and some similar things like that. My projects right here will take you to your current projects. Projects in Manage It are the civil engineer's blueprints that contain important work that can be stored organized here in Manage It. Right now, we do not have projects, but if we did, we would press on the plus to create one. So right here in your helpers will take you to this screen. Helpers and managers are civil engineers who have been in this field for a while and want to help newer people who have just entered the field. This can include helping by math help, reasonableness help, physics, any help that connects to civil engineering work. So let's say we wanted help. So we would press how to get help. Here it directs us to this page where helpers pop up based off the type of engineer that we are. So let's say we wanted Carlos help. Will take us to her profile. If we were interested in her help, we can message her.
Yeah, that was my video. Okay.
Hello, today I will be showing you all my Manage It app design.
Okay. Okay, so that was my little video demonstrating my app. So this is future work. Future work. So coding, there's logic. Logic to all screens. And it connects to the other point, which is database. So in what I showed you, I did not create an account. If I created an account, I would have to add logic, which would be if I entered a username or an email, or if I entered my name, a logic would be like, do not autocorrect, you know, because names are names. That's just how they're spelled. And database is where your data is stored. So the next time you enter the app, you will still be your name, your username, your bio. It stores and it knows what to do with the information. You put your username. All right, everybody sees that. You know, saves your passwords. And then I would also do a Facebook and Instagram business page to, like, you know, make it known that this app is here if you guys need help. I think you guys should use it. Entonces, el trabajo del futuro es poner. Logic to all screens database. Es hacer un código. Es hacer código. Entonces, en hacer código hay algo que se llama database. Y en database, eso es como. Divina, can you help me, please?
Yes, so lo que quiere hacer para el futuro es agregarle la lógica para su aplicación. También un método para poder guardar la información de los usuarios y también para hacer una página de Facebook y de Instagram, pero una página de negocio para poder ayudar para que gente sepa de la aplicación del servicio.
Thank you. Gracias. Questions? Preguntas?
Yeah. Wonderful. What questions do we have for Alay? And if anyone would like to pop their questions in the chat, I'm happy to read them out loud, or you can take yourself off mute and ask the questions directly, whatever you're most comfortable with.
¿No hay preguntas?
If nobody has a question, I can ask a question.
I have one. Oh, sorry.
Go ahead. If you have one, please ask.
I heard that at the beginning, she said, by the way, amazing job. At the beginning, you said that for civil engineers. So is it only for civil engineers or other engineering background folks can use it too?
So the app is specifically for civil engineers. It's civil engineers. It's a very broad term, if you will, because there's different types of civil engineers. But it just falls under the same umbrella. Anybody that's a civil engineer uses this app. It's based for civil engineers. It is for civil engineers. So, yeah.
I have a similar question regarding who the app is for from Jasmine. She's just curious to know why you are particularly interested in civil engineering.
So I was interested in civil engineering because my brother inspired me. He is a civil engineer, he's older, and I just thought his work was pretty interesting. I would see his blueprints, the math he would do, and I wanted to see. So I created this app inspired by him.
Wonderful. And why are you interested in civil engineering as a career?
So civil engineering It kind of has like math, physics, I guess geometry sometimes. And, you know, pretty interested in that. I'm kind of good at it. And I like it because there's one answer. Math, geometry, physics, it's only one answer, you know?
Mm-hmm.